Welcome to Shovelware Diggers. Our dig team is currently excavating the Softkey Shareware 2000 Hit Games 2CD collection. You can find a link in the video description containing the entire directory structure of this archive. It's week 18, and our dig team's decided to dig up a bunch of Windows games today. For more information on how to join the dig team, simply head on over to the Patreon page linked in the video description. Now, without further ado, let's begin. First up, a new digger, Spree, has decided to dig up WINGAMES / Puzzle 1 / Squeeze. Okay, let's see here. Puzzle 1, Squeeze. Not a lot in that Puzzle 1 area. So, SQ Play? Okay. Squeeze Play by Henderson Graphics from Texas. Registration $15 for the full version. Registration includes added bonuses, doesn't say what. Okay. So, what we appear to have here, I guess this is probably a game kind of like those, what was the name of that thing? It was that mouse game where you had to push the blocks around to trap the cats and stuff while collecting cheese. I'm guessing this game's going to be something like that, but let's see. Trap the spitting things. Yep, that's pretty much exactly what we got here, as a clone of that game. So, I wish I could remember the actual name of it right now, but... Whoa. Are they getting faster? I think they're getting faster. So, we've got a harder version, a harder clone of that game, apparently. Yeah, I was never actually that good at it to begin with, but the game I'm referring to is basically a game that was included with one of... Rodent's Revenge, that was the name of the game. Finally remembered that. But the idea was that you were trying to trap cats to get rid of them while collecting cheese for points. I was never any good at it. And this game is surprisingly difficult. One of the interesting things about this game, though, and in fact Rodent's Revenge itself, is that you can actually push multiple blocks at a time, which is kind of uncommon for games like that, for these kinds of puzzle games and such. I'm just trying to trap, like, one of them at least, to sort of validate that I know how to play this. They actually move pretty fast, too. Okay. They got one of them in there. I think we got one. Now, unless I push it twice by mistake. Oh, jeez. Wait a minute. No extra You only get one life? And you're expected to go through multiple levels? That can't be right. Actually, I just realized while reading the instructions that I had it on mute. So, if there were any sound effects playing, I absolutely did not hear them. I'm not hearing any sound effects. Yeah, they're moving slowly than they were just a little ago. So, they do move faster the longer you play for. Just... Okay, so there's one sound effect for when you get caught. That's strange, though, that you only get one extra... You get one life and that's it. Let's see what the custom game's about. So, basically... What kind of enemies, what kind of background, and what kind of blocks? Huh. Can't I at least just trap one of them? Jeez. Rodent's Revenge is actually a lot easier than this. Yeah, I'm terrible at these kinds of games. But hey, I gave it a try. I'm sure for people who like Rodent's Revenge, there's probably some enjoyment here, but this is definitely not a game for me. Next, Addicted Young decided to dig up WINGAMES / Arcade / S_D24. Kind of have a feeling I know what this might be, but I'm not entirely certain. Well, we got some sound effects for sure, so... Actually, we got a text file this time, too. Search and Destroy, version 2.4. So not Seek and Destroy, which was that game with the rotating camera and the helicopter and tank, but... At least he kept track of his versions. And he's saying that the registration fee is $10. Doesn't look like there's any restrictions on playing the Shareware version, but you never know. Okay, well, let's just try playing it. 20 days if you like the game. Yeah. Randy Baron. Deploy your ships, then try to sink the computers before it sinks yours. So this is basically a battleship clone I'm taking from this. With a massive board. Whoa. There better be some kind of power-ups or something to take that into account. Because with a board that big, a game like this would go on forever. Well, let's place. Oh, so it's click and drag. Okay. So, can I rotate them? It doesn't look like there's a way to rotate them. Help? Click the right mouse button while still holding down the left button. Okay, I want to tell you guys a little thing that happens with programming. It's something I didn't realize as a kid, but something I've come to notice later on in life, is that if a coder has this certain idea of how to do something, he's not going to potentially accept that it's not a good way of doing it. So instead of trying to make a better way of doing something, they'll just go out of their way to explain the method that they're trying to get people to do, even though it's not really that good a method. So right here, where this guy is saying, if you want to change the direction of the ship from vertical to horizontal or vice versa, click the right mouse button while still holding down the left button, he's sort of acknowledging that he's doing this because he wants to and not because it's the best way he should be doing it. And he's obviously capitalized because he's got a ton of people telling him, how do you turn the ship? How do you turn the ship? Because I couldn't figure it out. Ship deployment satisfactory? Yep. Okay, so just click anywhere. And he's already destroying one of my ships. What the heck? Well, on the plus side, it's, look at that. He's already getting another one of my ships. I haven't even found one of his yet. Seriously? I haven't even found one of his yet. Okay, I finally found one of his. So he's not just completely cheating. The game does end up going longer, though, because of the fact that the playfield is so much larger than an actual battleship playfield. In fact, that was one of the things they did when they made the computerized versions of battleship, was they actually implemented power-ups in order to speed things along, so that you could actually play the game multiple times in different settings and everything, with different rules going on. He's probably going to win at this rate, but... And I got three of his, and I'm screwed. There was some sound effects there, but they were actually kind of quiet, like, even for me. I'll enhance those sound effects in editing, but I barely heard what the guy said when I lost the game there. But I'm gonna guess if I hit no, it's probably gonna close the program. Yep. Classic sort of thing going on there. I just want to see if there's anything else going on here. So you can automatically deploy ships. Yeah, not too many options to the game either. I guess for what it is, it's pretty basic. Does what it's supposed to do, I guess. Kind of weird having a huge board like that, but then since you can just click, 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 it goes pretty quickly. So, I don't know. It's not bad. Very basic. That's all I gotta say. Before we get to Anton Panetta's actual dig, he did have a failed dig. WINGAMES/event/COTW, which, if you know what that acronym stands for, you already know why this failed. Yep, it's Castle of the Winds, version 1.1a. I've already covered this game in a filler video on my show, so I'm not going to cover it again, really. But if you guys don't know Castle of the Winds, it's just basically a dungeon crawl with magic spells and all kinds of stuff. It's actually pretty fun, so check out my filler video of it if you want to see a lot more to it. Anton Panetta's actual dig this week is WINGAMES/event/WINCOW. Watch, this is actually Castle of the Woods again, just in a strangely named folder. Actually, no, this can't be. So let's see what the readme says. Cow 5 for Windows? Or does it mean Cow V? Version 1 of... could be Cow V. From Bovine Software, go figure. This program may only be distributed with these three files intact, or else... Seriously? You're gonna, like, go kill people because you're a mad cow or something? Because they don't include the readme or something? Okie dokie, then. Let's actually see what we got here. Oh. I think we got a text adventure. Well, let's see. Please enter your name. I am me. Welcome to Cal V, with all the new improved farm action. Your quest to feed Uncle Willie's chickens and return some eggs. Return with some eggs. You may read a help file anytime by entering help. Enjoy the game. You're in your Uncle Willie's kitchen. On the table is a note from Uncle Willie saying that he wants you to feed his chickens and bring the eggs back to the kitchen. Will you be able to succeed? Probably not. So door to the north. Open door. Wait. I just typed in one of the most basic things you could ever type into a text adventure, and it didn't understand. Okay, that's not a good sign. You can't do the shortcut letters to move in directions. Oh boy. You're in the backyard. Uncle Willie's house and barn are behind you, and all around you the countryside is peaceful. Ah. Uncle Willie's kitchen is to the south. To the west, a path leads into the woods. To the east is Uncle Willie's chicken coop. There is some chicken feed here. Since I can't see the keyboard with my mic in the way, it can kind of be here. Oh, come on. Get chicken feed. Seriously? Okay, so you have to use the specific words they want you to use. Okay. So far, it's like, I guess it works, but, can I see my inventory? No? What the heck am I carrying? There may be more hidden commands. If you can't play the game, then who's gonna be inspired to actually look up your hidden commands, quote unquote? All I want to do is figure out that I'm actually carrying this chicken feed, but can I look around? Okay. So we want to go east. Lots of chicken here. Some of them look pretty hungry. The only way out of the coop is to the west. Feed Uncle Chili's with chickens to give you some eggs. Now you have to... Is it serious? Is this like... Okay, is the reason why this text adventure simple because there's virtually nothing to it? So let's go west and south. You bring the eggs triumphantly into Uncle Willie's kitchen. Uncle Willie is there and takes the eggs, congratulating you on a job well done. You have completed Cow V, the Great Egg Quest. Your final score is 20 out of 20. That was the shortest text adventure in the history of everything. And now the game actually isn't doing anything at all. Wow. Okay, there's gotta be more to it than this. Let's launch it again and see if I can find out some of those hidden commands. I can think of a few right off the bat that I want to try. I know the chicken are hungry. Let's see if we can kill them. No? Seriously? One thing that would have made this worth the effort. Let's see here. Let's go west. Eat feed. Take feed. Eat feed. Kill Willy. Kill Uncle Willy. Something? Talk to Willy. You can't even talk Willy. Talk Uncle Willy. Yeah. This game is... I don't know. Maybe if we look at the readme or the other file that was there, we can come up with some more ideas, because this just seems so basic, like beyond basic. We're talking like minimalist here. Super minimalist, even. So wait a minute. Were there actual, like, versions of the game before this one? Because the V is actually a 5, according to this. Cow 5 for Windows is a HippoWare product? Made by Bovine Software? If you use this program, you must send $10 to a local zoo specifying that the money should go towards the purchase of a new hippopotamus? What? I don't know what else to say about this thing, guys. It was the most basic text adventure you could possibly ever find, with virtually no adventure to it, and one item to get. No talking to characters, just an automatic usage of that item in the first place, not to mention automatic taking of the eggs following. So, I don't know. This is a thing. This is like, someone put this together for, clearly for a joke reason, giving that $10 to a local zoo thing, but I don't know. How this ended up in general circulation is anyone's guess, but whatever. It is what it is. 5 minutes of really basic entertainment.